Okay, what I'm going to talk about in this video is impact weapons. I had a few different designs here and we'll go over them briefly. Now, impact weapons are very, very basic. They've been around since, I take it, humans started walking this earth, and they've not really evolved much over the years. They're all very, very simple. These days, most impact weapons have been replaced by either the solid batons, the sidearm batons, or the extendable batons. I'm not a big fan of extendable batons because you have to extend them, and that takes time and it also takes space. I know there's a lot of guys online and girls online showing some sexy techniques to deploy a baton, but I would sooner have something like one of these if it was legal to carry. Because as soon as they're deployed, they're ready to work. As soon as they're out your pocket, etc. Again, most of these, apart from the old British police truncheon, are very, very concealable. Now, impact weapons, as I said, are simple. This is the old British police truncheon. And to put it in simple terms, it's a piece of wood. Some guys I know used to drill the ends, drill them, put some lead in there for extra weight. To be honest with you, I don't see any need to add extra weight to this. If you cracked somebody with this, they will feel it. I would not want to be hit in the head with one of these. Even though it's just a piece of wood, it's a stick, it's a very effective stick. So again, if we're looking at simple terms, impact weapons can be virtually anything you can hit somebody with. All right, these are just more Gucci versions. So that's the old British police truncheon. Effective, it works, even though people laugh at it. It worked for many years and it's an effective weapon. Now, moving on, this is a cosh. All this is a spring with some lead in the end. And this little one, even though it's very simple, very basic, this has also got a nice screw in the bottom for a lanyard. So not only do you have an impact weapon, you also have a weapon you can perform control techniques with. So again, this works as a little bit as a coup baton and also as an impact weapon. And again, it's very, very simple. I don't know where I got this from, but I don't think I paid much for it. And it works. Now, I should have said to start with, wherever you are, if you are collecting weapons or using weapons for classes or carrying weapons, make sure everything's legal. If you're carrying or working with them, make sure you have the right certifications. In some areas, this is where you must know the local laws. Just being in possession of a weapon can get you into trouble. Being in possession in a weapon with a weapon in public can get you into a lot of trouble. So always know the local laws, whether you're collecting or running self-defense classes or carrying for self-defense purposes, always make sure you're in full compliance with your local laws, because there's a lot of good people that end up having problems because they didn't know the law. So again, that's a little cosh. All it is, lump of lead on a spring. I came across a guy years ago that was traveling, said he was traveling to some place that wasn't too nice, and the only weapon he could find, he could pick up and improvise, was some old bed springs. They were so big, and he said they worked as a cosh, no problems. Springs work. This is an old East German border guard cosh truncheon. And all this is springs. And this is nasty. This is not gonna, well, you could kill somebody with it, but this is to wake people up. This is gonna hurt. This is a steel whip. If you're hitting somebody on flesh with this, they're going to feel it. Because all this is two springs. It's small, it's concealable, and it's going to hurt. Won't kill, but it's going to hurt. And all that is springs. Very, very simple. Need some oil. All this stuff needs oil and taken care of because it's been in storage for a while. So always look after your kit better than I do. This is a cosh, and this has got a lump of lead on the end. Underneath here, it's all braided leather. I've covered this in gripper tape. If you hit somebody in the head with this, they're gonna have big problems. And so are you, because you're most probably gonna at least fracture their skull, if not kill them. So this is the thing, if you're carrying impact weapons, even extendable batons, you have to be very careful that you don't use excessive force. This very handy weapon to keep in your pocket where legal, which it wouldn't be legal in many places, for carry, it's okay for demonstrations and to keep privately for demonstrations to collect. But again, if you're caught in public with something like this, you're gonna have a lot of problems. The beauty of these is they're very, very quick to deploy. And again, if you hit somebody with that, if you're hit with that, you're gonna have problems. That's gonna put somebody out, no problems, because that's a heavy, heavy cosh. Yeah, and again, all it is, a lump of lead on the end of the spring. That's concealable, stick it in your pocket, very quick to deploy, very, very effective. But you'd have to be careful because, as I said, you hit somebody in the jaw, they're going out, that jaw's getting broken. You hit somebody in the head, chances are you could fracture the skull. So the thing is with weapons is impact weapons, you don't want to use them and then be charged with using excessive force, etc. So again, you have to be very careful. This is a sap. And again, this is just a spring with a lump of lead on the end. Yeah. The flat side used against flesh, the edge used against bone. If you hit somebody with this, and this again has got a lump of lead in it, you hit them in the head, they're gonna have big, big problems. The beauty of these designs is they're nice and flat, they're very concealable. And again, security guys, if you're searching people, you come across something looking like this, and they've even got little coin bags these days that can be used as saps. It's a weapon. So again, flat, concealable, lump of lead on a steel spring. Hit somebody, the flat against flesh, the edge against bone, that's gonna do damage. Very handy. Now, all of these are weapons, right? You look at these are weapons. This is your basic hammer. I don't know where I picked this up, but it's a hammer. This is legal to carry in your car, legal in most places, you can buy them in stores. And again, this is a lot more deadlier than that. These are effective weapons. And again, they're impact weapons, they're meant for hitting things. So again, anything can be used as an impact weapon. This is just a stick, right? So anything can be used as an impact weapon. I collect these, I show these on courses, no problems. But when it comes down to weapons, anything can be turned into a weapon, anything can be improvised. So, just a little show and tell on a few things I've collected over the years. I used to have a lot more. This type of thing interests me. If you've got any questions, give me a shout. Send me a message, send me an email. I'm happy to answer your questions. And whether it's on street weapons, older weapons, self-defense, etc., I'm happy to hear from you. Many thanks for watching.